Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I've already covered how to do a mail merge using Outlook, Word, and Excel. The link to that video is up in the top right. It's also down in the description down below. It's one of my most popular videos. The question I've been getting lately is, what do you do if you've got multiple Outlook accounts? How do you pick which one will send the email? That is a great question, so let me explain how to do that. I've got Outlook on the desktop running. Two items you must do. Step number one is you want to go to File, Account Settings, Account Settings. You'll see all your email accounts right here. Find the email account you want to send from. So I had it, this was my default right here. I said, no, I want to send from Chris at chrismenard.net. Set as default, close. That was step one. The second step, still in Outlook, is File Options. Over on the left is Mail. Click on Mail. Grab your mouse and scroll down. You're looking for the Send Messages. This box right here, always use the default account when composing new messages, will not be checked by default. The answer is you do want to check this to make it work. Click OK. And then always test it. You technically don't have to test it, but I'm telling you to test it. So here I am in my Sent folder in Outlook. I have sent no emails in the last today, as you can see. Here's the Excel file in case you're saying, well, Chris, what exactly am I testing? There you go. At least put in a personal email account of yours just to test this. So there I am on row number three. Carol said I can test this using her email too. So there's two people. Close this. You got to close it to do the mail merge. So here's the test. Start Word. Again, I'm not going into details. Look at my video if you want to see this. I'm going to do email messages. Go find my recipient list, which is that Excel file. I want to put in, there are the two fields, dear Chris, Carol, whatever, comma. That works. Finish and merge. Send email messages. I'm going to call this budget meeting. I'm making this up. Click OK. After you click OK, go pop into Microsoft Outlook. Go to the account that you just set up as the default, and you also checked use this account as the default when sending messages. There you go right there. And one more item I've got concerning testing. So the test worked already. I would go pull up your personal email account where you did that just to take a peek at how that email message is going to appear. And there's that email that I just sent out with Dear Carol at the top. I hope this helps, and that is the answer to that YouTube question that I keep getting. Thank you for your time. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.